Why are you so ugly? What's growing on your face? Why do you look like a general in the Union Army, big guy? What's the deal?
All right, let's do this one more time. This is another question I get a lot, and it often comes in the form of a statement like, oh my God, you are ugly. Good thing you're funny because I am totally limp right now. So I'll explain it to you. This video is just gonna be me and my scented candle.
Gwyneth Paltrow, you nasty dog. So, it's been about a year since I've shown my face.
The finale of my SMP Live series ended with me killing the Ender Dragon, the music faded out, and surprise!
This is so stupid.
There he is! Please, there's my favorite white boy! Jesus Christ, I don't even remember this kid. I mean, I bullied this kid in high school. Like, this kid played devil's advocate in history class. This kid sucked dick in the locker room. Not that there's anything wrong with that. I remember uploading that video and just mindlessly scrolling through Twitter for the rest of the day. I was kind of terrified because thousands of accounts run by middle school girls had just changed their profile picture to the same image. Because that was all it is. It was just like a 15-second clip of me doing this face. So I was like, and that's what I looked like. And that's the only image there was. And there were edits of like me with fucking hearts around my face. Like it was so weird. I just didn't understand it. Like I couldn't wrap my mind around the fact that someone cared that much about a fucking Minecraft YouTuber. Like, bro, like pick up a goddamn football. I'm sorry, baby, you though. Pick up a football, get a job. The fucking geometry test is tomorrow. And the only thing you've been studying is your fucking Wattpad. Jesus Christ! Either way, though, the cat was out of the bag, you know? Everybody fucking knew what I looked like. Everybody knew what I looked like. Everybody was freaking out. And all I wanted to do was just curl up into a ball and roll off a cliff.
I'm sorry.
It was such a weird experience, because, like, I had spent so much time in my life, trying to protect my privacy and enjoying my privacy and enjoying the fact that my entire life was not just out to the public. All of a sudden, everybody knows what I look like. And the same day I uploaded that face reveal, I got on a plane to San Diego for TwitchCon. And I started meeting more people and taking more photos. And it just snowballed. Everybody was obsessing over it. There was like two images of me on the entire internet. And I don't know, it was so overwhelming, man. So there's that, you know? Clean-shaven Schlatt puts his face out there for the first time. What happens next? You know, why don't women like me anymore? Why do they start running away when I chase them down a dark New York City street subway station? I'll tell you why, baby. It's because of the chops. The fucking mutton chops. Who does this? Who looks like this? Ambrose Burnside. That's me. I got reincarnated. They call me Buddha. So, what started as like an extremely pedophilic Minecraft YouTuber mustache, which you can see on the first Misfits podcast I went on, eventually evolved into some scruff, and then eventually just became full-on mutton chops. Like, clean-shaven chin, nothing there. Why? Not just because I can't grow hair here. Not because I want you to see literally any character with facial hair ever and put fucking Jschlatt on it in fucking Impact. Not just because I want to separate myself from literally every other twink who does the same shit I do, but because when you think about it, it doesn't matter. Over this year, you guys have seen me become more and more comfortable with my face and putting my face out there. And you can see this in the first Wii video I ever uploaded, where I was playing bowling and like my head was not even in the shot because I was still kind of nervous about what I looked like. And then take one of the more recent videos I uploaded where I literally look like someone who would run up to you in New York City and start screaming at you. The chops have taught me something, fellas. They've taught me that it doesn't actually matter. I know I look weird, right? I mean, I like this. No one looks like this. And I know that whenever I'm driving or I'm somewhere where people can see me, they always fucking look at me and people always leave comments. I get, you have no idea, like the percentage of comments I get that are about my fucking facial hair. But I also know that when someone, you know, looks at me funny or leaves some mean comment, like it's gone like that. I'm never gonna see that person walk by again. He probably doesn't even know how to use a fucking blinker. And like this kid who left a mean comment. He's probably too scared to show his mom his report card. This person, look at their fucking bio. Are you kidding me? Listen. Am I gonna let the thoughts and the opinions of people whose lives mean absolutely fucking nothing to me dictate how I actually live? No. And fellas, ask yourself if you should either. This is a lesson that's been years in the making for me. And I'm not saying I'm perfect. You know, I'm not saying I've ascended to this point where I don't care about what anybody says
I still get very upset when people call me gay. But my journey with the chops is my journey of learning to not give a single shit about you.